This was Saturday night on Independence Day in Baltimore. About 300 people used a rope to yank down the statue of Christopher Columbus. This video, captured by Lewis Krause, shows the statue being thrown into the Jones Falls. On Monday morning, there's a visual trail from the piazza where the 14-foot statue stood down to the water.
It was a piece of art. It was beautiful. It was beautiful.
Former state senator, now lobbyist, John Pica organized plans to get the statue out of the water.
Italians are proud people. We're very proud. We're proud of all the contributions that Italy and Italians have made to culture, literature, science, math.
Divers from specialty underwater services and area crane companies volunteered to help as onlookers stopped to take pictures.
I am upset. I'm just sad.
She's one of the people I talked to who said she wants protest but doesn't agree with the way the statue came down.
I think that statue was eventually going to come down because everybody recognized that the concerns. But instead, vigilantes took it into their own hands and destroyed a statue that costs a lot of money.
Getting the statue out of the water is a challenge. Divers had to identify where it was, and it broke in several places, including the head. Divers then used pulleys to lift it out in pieces. In its original state, the statue is about 34,000 pounds, and this is the heaviest part. But now that they've collected most of the major pieces of this statue, it's now going to be taken to an undisclosed location where it will be restored.
We're going to replace the statue with another Italian who we're proud of. We're looking at Michelangelo, Da Vinci, Amerigo Vespucci, and come up with a consensus. Someone with no stain.
Megan Pringle, WBAL-TV 11 News.